out their families.
I taste metal, I taste blood.
You're not invincible, and God's gonna deal with you!
This is a slow-moving, right-wing coup.
And the Oscar goes to...
Stop being gilded, domesticated garbage. It's like scum, Nazi filth, trash, garbage, maggots. We know we're under attack! We know it! We're breaking the conditioning! You know what it's like to go to sleep every night knowing you work for a bunch of psychotic killers and you bastards are probably gonna end up killing me one day? Going into space, mathematics, quantum mechanics, the secrets of the universe, it's all there. Life is fiery with its beauty, its incredible detail. Tuning into it, stop being weak. You know what it's like knowing you ruined my life? You know what it's like, you sons of bitches? They want to shatter your mind talking about Justin Bieber. We got a bunch of criminals coming down on us. Murdering scum. I want to unleash humanity. Not have a bunch of con artists, pot-bellied, chicken neck, pieces of garbage running our world. You commit evil, you're part of an evil system, and we're standing up against you.
There's a nasty taste coming up in my mouth. I'm tasting those globalists.
I can taste their fear and their weakness.
I taste metal, I taste blood.
And pulling up the image of Bill Gates, that piece of garbage, and all the stuff he's done to innocent people makes me want to throw up. I tell you, we're going to get people awake to you, you bastards, and we're coming for you. We're coming straight for you, and you know it. That's why you're so scared. Ah! It's pure evil! They're taking your intellect, your soul, and giving you Michael Jordan and Bieber. 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. And you just better keep doing that dance, because you can feel that flame of rebellion starting to lap up and lick right up there. I know I'm in a scientific matrix grid in the early phases of being inserted into an extermination system. I'm like, oh, shocked by it, so I'm up here bashing it because I don't like gay people. I don't like them putting chemicals in the water that turn the friggin' frogs gay. Serious crap. You can't get up there and say you learned from me that black people aren't humans, asshole. They're atheists that don't believe in God and the devil, but they go ahead and say, I worship Lucifer. Like the head of the liberal movement, Saul Alinsky, dedicated his book to Lucifer. But they believe they're building Lucifer. Because humans can envision and build whatever they imagine with enough time and energy.
I've never found one of them that doesn't say, I love the devil.
We go to Atlantic City, New Jersey. You're on the air.
Yes, good morning. I listen to Alan Jones religiously from 2 in the morning to 5 in the morning on Real One Radio on the Internet. If anybody really wants information, he is the man who has it, believe me.
Let me just ask our caller, why is it that you believe what Alex Jones tells you?
Because he makes a lot of sense. There are just too many coincidences about the whole situation from George Bush's coup. And, totally.
Who is Alex Jones? Why does he have the truth? And why is everything that he says reliable? Who, do you know anything about him? Do you know where he was born? Do you know how much education he's got?
It just makes sense, believe me. It just makes sense, because the other way just doesn't make sense. And I know there's evil behind the Skull and Bones. Everything's staged. Everything that the Skull and Bones do is staged.
You would explain this to someone who never even heard of such a thing in a real concise manner. What is the New World Order?
It is a hereditary clan that rules through the fraudulent fractional reserve monetary banking scam that operates through intelligence systems and shadow governments.
these same allegations were made in the late 1790s against the Illuminati, then the Freemasons, then the Jesuits, then the Jewish bankers in the Protocols of the Elders of Zion from Russia, an apocalyptic conspiracy theory about Jewish bankers. Then it was the Rockefellers. Then it was the Council on Foreign Relations. And a lot of these people who make a big deal about the Bilderbergers really have this closet agenda of trying to suggest to you it's the Jewish bankers like the Rothschilds. And if you're talking about the folks from the American Free Press, that's their agenda. That's an organization that was founded by one of the biggest anti-Semitic neo-fascist conspiracy theorists in the world, Willis Cardo. So yes, I've investigated both sides of this question, and I'm quite sure of what I'm saying.
The terrible thing about the Illuminati was that they were against kings and they were against the church. And of course, America also begins as a country that was against kings and against the church. But once it becomes a country, there's, you know, a group of people that are worried about its revolutionary basis.
How many go there every year?
Oh, a lot, like 1,000 people.
At one time?
Yeah, that's why I managed to walk up the drive so easily. Now, I snuck in with Alex Jones, this far right wing conspiracy theorist who believed that the cremation of care proved that the secret rulers of the world practice human sacrifice.
The figure of a human body burning in the flames. In fact, I've shown it to people that are experts in anatomy, to actual doctors, and they say that the anatomical size is that of a baby or small child. The entire compound was literally infested with symbols of death, skulls, owls. At long last, here it is, the cremation of care unveiled. This is what the establishment is into right here in America.
What happened with me and Alex was that we both witnessed this owl burning ceremony, and I realized that it was a silly, grown-up frat kind of nonsense. And the only thing that shocked me was this is, you know, how the President of the United States wants to spend his summer vacations witnessing this, you know, torch-like procession, which I thought was kind of odd. But Alex, of course, had his own spin on it, which was that it was human sacrifice. Maybe that's a real person there. So I went off with my spin, which was, you know, a kind of moderate spin. Then it's not that crazy, it's understandable. And Alex went back to his people with his own incredibly crazy spin. And, you know, just a couple of weeks ago, an Alex Jones fan tried to break into Bohemian Grove heavily armed and kill everybody there because he believed Alex Jones's spin of the owl ceremony as being evidence of human sacrifice.
Absolutely disgusting. George Bush is a conservative. He's not for family values. He is nothing but a Luciferian twin. A Luciferian twin, Bush. You may think you're being on the other side of the way. We're sitting over here. We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Along with the Constitution and death to the New World Order.
And I remember at the time, because I'm, you know, Alex is an intelligent man, and I remember at the time saying to him, Alex, you know that what you're saying about Bohemian Grove isn't true. You know, you're playing with fire here. And Alex said, yeah, I'm not going to tell my listeners that. And it's kind of come back to haunt him now.
A Luciferian devil worshipper.
So underlying all this is pretty serious stuff.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Alex is kind of crazy funny, and the adventures, you know, that I have in the book are funny. You know, I wanted to write a funny book, but always, you know, remembering that these people are chilling people. They may be buffoons, but, you know, they resonate.
I want you to understand that this little series that we're doing is nothing personal against Alex Jones or anybody else. But I happen to know for a fact, absolute fact, and listen to me very carefully, that people who practice this kind of broadcasting and claim to be an American patriot do nothing but discredit all of us eventually. It's wrong. It is absolutely wrong. And it's wrong to allow that to happen, especially when the host takes it and runs with it without any checking, without any calling, without any research, without anything.
Vladimir Putin, who is known as Vladimir the Ruthless. This person is on an unbelievable power trip and resembles a demon. And this information is vital, ladies and gentlemen. We are seeing the New World Order really come out in full force. More wars than have been in the last 50 years are going on right now.
Is that true, folks? Are there more wars going on right now than in the last 50 years? Are there hundreds of thousands of people dying right now in Chechnya? Listen to this. This man is just making it up right out of his head as he goes along.
As Russia threatens to attack us with nuclear weapons, as nuclear power plants, at least one, are being shut down, 20 to 40,000 civilians trapped in the city, Russian Hinds are being shot down, tanks are being blown to bits, massive Grad unguided rocket attacks are being launched on the city indiscriminately right now, air and artillery bombardments as well. It's absolutely out of control. It is pandemic, ladies and gentlemen.
What was the main thing that he concentrated on?
That Russia was imminently going to attack the continental United States.
You got it. That we were going to be nuked by Russia.
Right.
He spent 45 minutes of the first hour preparing his radio audience to believe that Russia was going to nuke us because of Y2K. Now, he claims that he's always said that Y2K would amount to nothing and nothing would happen. Well, you can see by what you listened to that that's not true. He was promoting it. And I listened to his show this morning. He's still saying that everything, what he's doing is pulling all the normal news that normally occurs that nobody ever pays any attention to, and he's blaming every bit of it on Y2K. If a little town loses their power for a few hours, it's Y2K.
Lift weights less. I jog and hike less. I still eat what I was eating before. I can eat like a pig and not even exercise that much, and I have lost now almost 80 pounds.
My friends, we have done it. With Dr. Group's help, we have developed the ultimate male vitality supplement with 8 concentrated super herbs.
Now, a lot of you that listen to the syndicated radio show hear once a week or so Ted Anderson, who's the owner of the Genesis Radio Network, but he also got into radio because he was sponsoring radio, owning Midas Resources, now the 5th largest gold and silver broker in the country. And Ted's been a sponsor of mine for almost 16 years now, even before I was on his Genesis Network, when I was just on local radio here. I wanted to thank Ted Anderson for all of his support of the network and his company, Midas Resources. And Ted, gold's up over $20 today. And you have some great deals you're able to buy when gold dipped for a few weeks. You're able to pass those on to people. But the real economy is imploding. The banks are looting us. People need to get into silver and gold. It's up over 400%. Because the globalists obviously want to hoard gold themselves while using paper to try to suppress the price. Dollar index headed for rapid collapse.
In most industries, if you make predictions that don't come true, you eventually go out of business or you're off the air. There's a huge uproar. But for some reason, when it comes to economic collapse, no matter how many times people predict it and it doesn't happen, as long as they make the next prediction, everybody gets all hyped up again. I just don't understand this phenomenon, so I thought I would understand it from the people who are perpetrating it.
Soros is buying the gold because he knows what's going on. He's an insider. He can see it.
This is obviously a gold pitch, and it shows the dollar plunging massively. I buy my gold and silver from Midas Resources. In bullion, gold and silver, you can't beat the prices.
I think it's ridiculous to make a living off of the backs of the people who trust you and are listening to you because they've been told that the mainstream is lying to them. So where else do they have to go? And you seem to be the biggest thing in alternative, so I must trust you because the biggest thing in mainstream was always the biggest thing, and that's what I'm used to. So I'm going to go look over here and trust everything that I'm saying because, you know, everybody has the documents. Well, they don't realize that they are being catfished. They are being suckered into purchasing things that aren't going to save them from anything because nothing's going to happen.
The dollar in just 11 years has lost massive amounts of its value. How do you protect yourself? Well, I believe you do it by getting gold and silver. We need to start a movement to have Congress take back control of the purse and to kick the Federal Reserve out of this country. I think we've got a pretty darn good track record of predicting what's happening. Get into gold today, folks. The Koch brothers have funded the Democrats as well as the Republicans, and they're just basically apolitical, but they're not complete communists.
One, they don't fund Democrats. Two, apolitical. One of them bought their way onto the Libertarian Party ticket 30 years ago, before they had multiple billions of dollars. They have spent in the past 4 years almost $1 billion in funding Heritage Foundation, Heartland, Hillsdale College, Freedom Works, the Americans for Freedom for Prosperity, the Tea Party. Freedom for freedom for freedom.
But they've had their pipeline down to Texas shut down, which I'd like to have a pipeline. I'd like to have more oil from Canada instead of Saudi Arabia.
And the Keystone XL pipeline, which they have a huge interest in, the Koch brothers, is going to ship that oil down to refineries in the Gulf and be sold to China. It is not going to replace any Saudi Arabian oil in this country, not one drop of it. Saudi Arabian oil makes up a tiny fraction of our imported oil. Most of our imported oil comes from Canada and Mexico. How is it possible that Alex Jones doesn't know this?
But of all the virulent forms of centralized mega rich, they're on a scale of 1 to 10 of being inside operators. I'd make them about a 4. Whereas Warren Buffett's a 10. David Rockefeller's a 10. Lord Rothschild's a 10. I mean, they're in there driving the agenda. The globalists hate the Koch brothers because they're not for carbon taxes.
Don't pay attention to the guys who are putting $1 billion into American politics. Pay attention to Lord Rothschild and all the people coming out of Mount Shasta. That is the perfect example of why Alex Jones is so dangerous. He takes people who have legitimate concerns that we're getting screwed over by the very wealthy who have aligned interests and gives them some type of rubber ducky toy to play with that is all about conspiracies and Bilderbergers and people talking to owls in the woods. That's the real truth is over here.
The Koch brothers, from what I've read of these meetings, put out a lot of really good information. You know, all this sounds really great what the Koch brothers are doing.
Mayer reveals that Fred Koch helped build an oil refinery in Nazi Germany, a project approved personally by Adolf Hitler. The refinery was critical to the Nazi war effort. Its oil fueled German warplanes. Before that, Fred Koch built a refinery for Joseph Stalin's Russia. Fred Koch went on to become an original leader of the right-wing John Birch Society. Charles Koch was a member when the group campaigned against the civil rights movement in the 60s.
My parents had friends that were in the John Birch Society, guys that worked at the telephone company, FBI agents, cops, lawyers that would come by the house. They basically have John Birch meetings and talk about the New World Order and the plans for the country and the three mega regions and how they transfer our liberties into foreign treaties. Everything that's basically 90% complete.
From the minutes of the first meeting of the John Birch Society National Council on January 9th, 1960. This is John Birch Society founder Robert Welch. Today, gentlemen, I can assure you without the slightest doubt in my own mind that the takeover at the top is, for all practical purposes, virtually complete. Whether you like it or not, and whether you believe it or not, our federal government is already literally in the hands of the communists.
If you look historically, like at the Palmer Raids, and then again at the Red Scare of the 50s, and then again at the political repression that the FBI launched under the COINTELPRO program, you see the fear of radicalism and of Bolshevism time and time again being articulated, but I think it's important to understand that it's not a fear of real radicalism or real communism or real socialism or real subversion. It's what Frank Donner in The Age of Surveillance calls a Manichaean construct. It's a paranoid, hyperbolic fear of what is perceived to be communist. And why that's important is, as you see some of the authoritarian style Leninist regimes collapse, some of the excuse for fighting communism obviously collapses with it, and yet you don't see any diminution of repressive forces. But real communism was never the issue, it was the perception.
The police are more awake than the public probably five times. If George Soros wants us to have a war with the police, what does that tell you?
So are you willing to tell me that every single person that you've seen at Black Lives Matter, even the white people, are murderers?
Are we talking about the same issues here?
You just said that Black Lives Matter are promoting murdering cops. Are you being specific to one
person? Yeah, I think the whole black nationalist movement, AP's got an article today, police agencies on edge, on guard amid heightened threats, attacks on police inspired or directed by militant groups.
Hit pause. That one's soft right there. That guy joined the force because I guarantee you he's the type of guy that bullied kids that were smaller than him. Then those kids grew up and kicked his ass. I know those types. I've seen that face. And now they love it. They can abuse and beat up everybody and nobody can stop them. Nobody can stop them. They're having their way with America. They want our guns. And if you're not with them, cops and military, then you will declare that you're with the Republic now. You commit evil, you're part of an evil system, and we're standing up against you. And the Republic is going to defeat you in the end. Some of us won't make it personally through this, but a lot of us are. And in the end, you are going to be brought to justice.
I'm shot, I think, maybe in two places. Okay, what's your name?
My name is Richard Poplawski.
Okay, and where are you at?
In my residence at 1016 Fairfield Street.
Just have to take care of it. Okay, hold on a minute, honey, okay? Yeah. Okay, and what, do you want to come out? Want to give yourself up or what?
I can't give myself up because I'm laying in a pool of blood and I can't really move, but I'm done taking innocent police officers' lives, so if they would come and get me, and that would be great.
What, do you have any weapons on you?
I got plenty of weapons on me, but I'm not shooting any more cops because my weapons are either out of ammunition or they're disabled.
Death, death, death. Hey, don't worry. The bankers are going to take everything you got, cops. You think you can just deal death on us and deal pain on us? You don't think there aren't bigger devils above you in the New World Order that'll have their way with you? You think you're safe from evil?
They take these examples of bad cops and create the perception that the police are out killing everybody.
And so that's why when I'm driving down the road and there's lanes on both sides of me, Austin cop, no lights on, just run right up behind you with pleasure. And then swing around and almost hit you. And then just sit there with a light in your face going, you son of a bitch, citizen, you are slave, civilian, I rule you.
He always said that if anyone tried to take his firearms, he was going to stand by what his forefathers told him to do and defend himself. And I guess he went about it the wrong way. He just basically told me he didn't like the Zionist control over our government. He didn't like that there was about to be military policing. He didn't believe in the fact that there was about to be a gun ban. He didn't like anything that was going on the political forefront.
One of these idiots at the Austin TSA a few months ago come over and go, you're a troublemaker, Alex Jones. And I thought it was a joke. It was so pathetic and worm-like. Statistically, you're getting cancer from the scanners. Statistically, you guys have incredible high crime rates of robbing, raping, stealing from people. Don't sit there on your goody two-shoes throne where you, the government, are good and I'm bad. That's what it's all about. It's about this crook government teaching us we have to listen to them and put up with all their garbage and suck their boots, whatever they say, and as they suck off on us with our their taxes and all their regulations and all their bugging their eyes out at us and cops strutting around everywhere trying to intimidate the public. This isn't what a free country looks like. It's what a rat-infested third world cesspit looks like. You guys aren't protecting America. You're helping deep six it for the traitor bankers that have taken over this country. And I'm sick of you, and I want you out!
Poor CNCO walked into Terminal 3 at LAX on Friday, pulled out a gun, and started shooting. He injured several people, including three officers from the Transportation Security Agency. One of them was Gerardo Hernandez, who was checking passenger IDs at the time. In the chaos that followed, CNCO headed up the escalator. Then he saw Gerardo Hernandez move, so he went back and killed him.
The FBI agents who searched Paul Ciancia's apartment had a search warrant for his cell phone. They found it in his roommate's car. The warrant states they were looking for information relating to Ciancia's views on the legitimacy or activities of the United States government, including the existence of a plot to impose a new world order. Shortly after the rampage, police say they found a one-page letter in Ciancia's bag. It said he targeted TSA agents to, quote, instill fear in your traitorous minds, and also mentioned NWO, or New World Order. That's a century-old conspiracy theory, according to Mark Potok, who tracks extremist groups.
Basically identifies the federal government as an evil malefactor that is involved in a conspiracy to force the United States into a so-called one world government, known as the New World Order.
Online talk shows perpetuate these anti-government views.
Federal security goon force?
And often mention TSA officers.
Investigators described Jared and Amanda Miller as anti-government and on a mission to kill police officers. The couple entered this pizzeria around 11:30 yesterday and shot officers Igor Soldo and Alan Beck at point-blank range. The Millers then covered the bodies with a swastika and a Gadsden flag, first used in the American Revolution, emblazoned with the words, "Don't tread on me." Las Vegas Assistant Sheriff Kevin McCahill.
Mr. Jared Miller then penned a note to Officer Saldo that basically stated that this is the beginning of the revolution.
The Millers then walked to a Walmart a block away. Jared Miller fired his handgun and ordered shoppers out. He was confronted by Joseph Wilcox, a shopper who was carrying a concealed weapon.
As soon as he began to confront Jared Miller with his firearm, Amanda Miller removed her firearm and shot him one time in the ribs area, and where he immediately collapsed.
The couple barricaded themselves in the back of the Walmart and had a gunfight with SWAT teams. It ended when Amanda Miller shot her husband and then herself.
For those of you that are out there that are skeptical of chemtrails, here's one for you right here. They're spraying it right now.
Not condensation trails, ice crystals, no. But barium salts, aluminum dioxide, other nuclei mixed in so that it creates a artificial haze. You don't just think they put that in the Matrix movies, you know, 10 years ago because they thought that up about a global plan to black out the sun. If you don't play ball with them, they'll just spray you and shut down your weather.
But yes, all these clouds in the sky that you see right now, they're all artificial clouds. They sprayed them earlier. Anyway, those of you that don't think chemtrails are real, I don't know if you know or not, but our government has fully admitted that they do that.
Disorders of the brain, neurological disorders skyrocketing. They're now saying, oh, it's normal to get Alzheimer's when you're 25. It's normal to have narcolepsy, and they admit the shots are doing that. There's all sorts of bizarre spraying.
They are taking your money to spray chemicals on you so you can get cancer and Alzheimer's. It's all part of their grand scheme for population control.
This is about genocide and population reduction. They're spraying us with barium salts, sodium fluoride in our water.
Not to mention that, you know, they're fluoridating our water, they're feeding us GMO foods.
Look, I mean, it's over. We're being mass murdered by Nazi criminals that run everything. And meanwhile, they have all these newspapers attacking me because I'm exposing them.
Sorry to say, guys, but none of us stand any kind of chance of living maybe past 50, 60 years old. What are you going to do about it? Huh? I'm going to sit around the world and I can't do about it?
There are things we can do about it. Just gotta be willing.
All right, you're arguing? We're taking your children to this area. They're getting shots. Sir, America's in trouble. We're just trying to do our job. This is exactly how it's going to be. He calls a disturbance. Send him to Camp 7.
They've been one world order. With me at the head of it. I will be able to take all these FEMA concentration camps. Not only imprison Americans, but other dissidents from other countries that don't want to go along with my plans and the New Order's plans to vaccinate you with all these flu shots and hepatitis shots that give you little drops of mercury and causes cancer and infertility.
So we gave 100 million Americans, as estimated, all these new rare cancers in a cocktail of viruses in your polio vaccine, the live vaccine we shoot up kids' noses. What's the big deal, pumpkin? Isn't dying young fun? I mean, these people are assaulting us under common law, ladies and gentlemen. They could all be rounded up and hung. Okay, but they've got Homeland Security geared up to try to keep the clamps down while they murder us slow. They love the fact they're killing you and your family. They enjoy it. And then they'll put you on a helicopter, fly you 100 miles, and there it'll be, you son of a bitch, you want to cause problems? Come here, Jones. Knock your teeth out, you son of a bitch. I used to see your website, and I used to come. Die, you son of a bitch. Yeah, we rule America. Hell yeah. Ooh, 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 ooh.
I want to blow up whole countries, whole nations. I want to make everybody submit to one world order governance.
Officer, what's this checkpoint? What's going on? Get out of the car. Hey, officer, I'm not going anywhere. Your papers aren't in order.
But I'm...
That's it. They argued with us. Patriot Act. Patriot Act.
Bill, where are you going?
The children are crying. Well, they're just waiting. And they have those camps all over the world, and they're just waiting, just psychos. The dungeon keepers. And they love it. They love the humiliation. They love the screams of pain. And they would take turns beating, beating and beating. Oh, I love the demonic power. Just seething with hatred, seething with evil. That's their spirit, crushing it. That's who we're facing. Degenerate scumbag filth everywhere, feeding on you and your family. We're going to beat these bastards. They're not going to stop us.
Like an hour ago, you said the government's gang raping us. Now, I mean, you got to tone down your rhetoric, Alex, for real. You've been saying it for years that the government wants
to... No, the government is gang raping us.
Don't you realize that there's a segment of your listening audience that really is deranged? And when they tell you, when you tell them...
Oh, this is a classic talking point. Classic talking point, Southern Poverty Law Center, that I am going to cause deranged people to go out and do things. No, the government giving nukes to North Korea could cause World War III. What's funny and why the Joker's laughing all the way to the bank is because the more they abuse you, the more you enjoy it. It's like the Stockholm Syndrome. And so that's why the joke is on you.
Under arrest in Washington, 28-year-old Edgar Welch accused of firing an assault weapon inside the Comet Ping Pong pizza restaurant. Welch allegedly told police he came to investigate Pizzagate, an internet rumor alleging a Clinton campaign child sex ring. The Pizzagate conspiracy began with the Clinton WikiLeaks and an email stolen from campaign chief John Podesta about a fundraiser involving the restaurant. Users of the anonymous online message board 4chan, known for rogue political discussion, suggested without any proof whatsoever that the word pizza was code for child sex trafficking at the restaurant.
The websites also claim that there is a secret underground tunnel running from the pizza restaurant up the store to the Politics and Prose bookstore to traffic in children. But the bookstore says there is no tunnel.
For weeks, the restaurant and bookstore have received dozens of threats each day.
WikiLeaks has come out and linked to sites that are reporting this is about child trafficking. And I went and looked on WikiLeaks, and they're not even denying this. The media is totally ignoring it. Like young children, 6, 7, 8 years old in hot tubs for entertainment. I just can't believe this. I can't believe our country is so conquered by evil, Joe. And that we have fallen this low that this has to come out to break them and to break their evil. You will be broken. It's why you're already collapsing.
The Bible's the cries of the innocents are very powerful. And these people get power off hurting children, but those cries went up they've been heard, and now it's up to the viewers to take action. And now it's up to the viewers to take action. And now it's up to the viewers to take action. And now it's up to the viewers to take action. And now it's up to the viewers to take action.
Alex Jones here with an important note to our viewing, listening, and reading audiences. I'm going to read to you from a statement that's also posted to Infowars.com that I wrote yesterday. I want our viewers and listeners to know that we regret any negative impact our commentaries may have had on Mr. Alifanis, Comic Ping Pong, or its employees. We apologize. To the extent our commentaries could be considered as negative statements about Mr. Alifanis or Comet Ping Pong. And we hope that anyone else involved in commenting on Pizzagate will do the same thing.
Think about this.
Who does this to kids?
The Pizzagate narrative, as least as concerning Mr. Alifanis and Comet Ping Pong, we have subsequently determined was based upon what we now believe was an incorrect narrative. You want the worst stuff? We're going to see video of a toddler getting chopped up.
We have all the proof. We have all the proof.
Tonight, disturbing new allegations about the 28-year-old Army vet police say was caught on video moments after stabbing and killing 66-year-old Timothy Kaufman on Monday night. James Jackson facing a judge today, looking angry as prosecutors called the murder a hate crime, most likely an act of terrorism. Adding that Jackson considered this murder practice before going to Times Square to kill additional black men.
It's well over 10 years that he has been harboring these feelings of hate towards male blacks.
Police say Jackson traveled from Baltimore to New York, that he had stalked numerous potential victims and was angered by black men mixing with white women. Jackson turned himself in, admitting he's a white supremacist, police say, telling them where to find the 26-inch sword used to kill Kaufman.
And the way Dallas was, if you went in the poor white area, you got attacked. Poor black area, you got attacked. But the blacks were the most aggressive. In this book, it's very powerful. White girl bleed a lot. Dealing with, racial attacks against whites being organized nationwide. Now the media is basically covering it up. Look at that white girl. She got double D's, baby. I want you. Black folks walk by us and make more racial comments about, hey, cracker ass, I'm going to take your woman. Black guys walk by baring their teeth, bowed up, saying, you want to fight? We're going to give you Satan worship music, and we're going to give you kill cops, run around and sling drugs, and have big grills on your teeth so you stand out like an idiot so you can get killed or on drugs or put in a giant FEMA camp. And you let your kid dress up in stupid hip-hop gangster punk outfit, people that bend over, you know, in prison. I'm inducted as a punk to be gang raped and given HIV in prison. There is freakish racism against whites now being promoted everywhere. It looks like they're pushing it so hard and the left is so racist that at the end of the day, it's just going to become that because if you're white, you won't be able to be in any area that has people that aren't white in it because you'll be killed. And I guess that's the goal. And I mean, just whoever's behind it, it sure is working. We all have been conditioned as Republicans or as libertarians or as white people to be, oh my gosh, we're loving, you know, we're not racist. Yes, please, you know, do whatever. I'm sorry, I'm white. Beat ourselves with whips on the head. And then meanwhile, the Democrats have just recreated the Ku Klux Klan movement, but they've done it with minorities.
It's particularly ridiculous when they come out and call for my arrest by twisting things I've said, claiming that I want violence. Truly, these people have no shame.
What the fuck's your problem? You want to sit here and say that I'm a goddamn fucking Russian? You get in my face with that, I'll beat your goddamn ass, you son of a bitch. We go out and talk to Bernie Sanders supporters. They can hardly talk.
Free! Free! I want free stuff!
You need to have your jaws broken! I will. I'll do it right now. I'll get in the ring with you, and I will break your jaw. I will knock your teeth out. I will break your nose, and I will break your neck. You coward. You think you're a tough guy messing with little cameraman people. You want to sit there and defame me and the president? Get in a ring with me. I will break your jaw in seconds. I will smash your nose into a bloody pulp, and I will rack your teeth out. My fists are going to be bleeding with your teeth marks all over them. You frick. fucking bully, you coward. I hate you. My listeners hate you. And remember that scumbag forever. We're going to defeat this anti-human scum. We're going to wreck their
world. I'm not a Republican. The point I keep making, this whole Democrat-Republican deal is a complete... People always go back to that, though. And it's all the same people behind closed doors. It's just a big joke. And your leadership, our leadership, it's all the same people. I mean, it's a... You do see a fight going on, but it's two different management teams of the same system, you know, bidding for control. What I call the CEO jobs of Slavery Incorporated.
I mean, again, okay, Obama's bad. We're going to feel like winners by going for Mitt Romney. And it's all the same joke over and over again. It's so childlike. They trick you to make you think you've got a choice so that, oh, you're like a winner. And it's that idea that keeps us bound in bondage.
Hillary Clinton, I think, is a terrific woman.
In the 90s, Donald Trump brought his sons to the White House, writing, "The First Lady is a wonderful woman who has handled pressure incredibly well." Bill Clinton and Trump played golf.
Well, they're members of my club, and I like both of them very much.
And remember this? The Clintons at Mar-a-Lago for Trump's wedding to Melania.
I said, be at my wedding, and she came to my wedding.
I thought it'd be fun to go to his wedding because it's always entertaining.
Then there is Ivanka and Chelsea, young mothers and friends on the New York social scene.
We're children and we love our parents, so that's the great equalizer, and that's the great common ground.
Trump contributed to Hillary Clinton's past campaigns and to the Clinton Foundation. The former president even met with Trump just before he entered the race.
Did you call Donald Trump and ask him to run for president of the United States?
No.
Because that would be pretty smart, man.
Yeah.
The capture of political and economic power by a tiny cabal of elites is characteristic of the twilight of all empires, including ancient Rome, where a small group of oligarchic families exchanged power among themselves as civic institutions became a farce and the state disintegrated under mounting repression, corruption, and the folly of endless war.
You do see a fight going on, but it's two different management teams of the same system, you know, bidding for control.
I'm endorsing Donald Trump for president 2016 all the way. Donald Trump knows what's going on. He wants to defeat the globalist.
I can't believe what our country is doing. Gaddafi in Libya is killing thousands of people. Nobody knows how bad it is. And we're sitting around, we have soldiers all over the Middle East, and we're not bringing them in to stop this horrible carnage. And that's what it is. It's a carnage.
Well, nothing like having a chicken-necked globalist like Hillary Clinton, who flies around in armored Air Force Threes, making jokes and requoting and butchering Julius Caesar quotes of "I came, I saw, I conquered." Gaddafi's been killed without a trial. You'll die too, Hillary. And I wish no harm upon you. I want you to live out a long life with all your evil.
But we have to go in to save these lives. These people are being slaughtered like animals. It's horrible what's going on. It has to be stopped.
Libya was helping all of Africa, funding real projects. Compared to the globalists, Muammar Gaddafi was basically a saint. I just have to tell the truth.
Immediately go into Libya, knock this guy out very quickly, very surgically, very effectively.
They went in and took him out, folks. And now all Africa is going into the abyss. Love CNN. I love Fox. I love MSNBC. They're so truthful. They're so great. Funding the Arab Spring, supporting it. Oh, my God. Trump's so horrible for saying no to that the last few years. Trump was so wrong in 2003 for being against the Iraq war.
Are you for invading Iraq?
Yeah, I guess so.
The more I research what you've actually said and done, it's amazing. You were the only leading American figure who openly said, do not go to war in Iraq.
I just want to finish by saying your reputation's amazing. I will not let you down. You will be very, very impressed, I hope. A year into office, you'll be saying, wow, I remember that interview. He said he was going to do it, and he did a great job.
If I'm elected president,
You have to take out their families. When you get these terrorists, you have to take out their families.
You have to wipe out their homes where they came from. You have to absolutely wipe them out.
You might use it in Europe?
No, I don't think so, but
well,
I'm not
just
taking...
say it. I'll never use a nuclear weapon in Europe.
I am not taking cards off the table. I'm not going to use nukes, but I'm not taking any cards off the table.
The trouble is that the sane people hear you, and the insane people are not affected by your threats.
Would there be a time when it could be used? Possibly.
Okay,
I'd blow up every single inch. There would be nothing left. I would bomb the shit out of them. I would just bomb those suckers.
Let's give the power back to the people. And Donald Trump taking a big step today in foreign policy. Trump sat down for me with former Secretary of State Henry Kissinger.
I think it's a good thing. I mean, they know each other. They've talked by phone.
Everything evil you can imagine, Kissinger's always involved in it.
What's your feeling about President-elect Donald Trump, who you've met with?
It is an extraordinary opportunity. And I believe he has the possibility of going down in history as a very considerable president.
The immigration of Jews from the Soviet Union is not an obligation of the American foreign policy. And if they put Jews into gas chambers in the Soviet Union, it is not of America's concern, Henry Kissinger.
I happen to believe that Henry Kissinger was one of the most destructive secretaries of state in the modern history of this country. I am proud to say that Henry Kissinger is not my friend. Count me in as somebody who will not be listening to Henry Kissinger.
I mean, you can tell Bernie Sanders is as dumb as a pile of steaming dog crap. Oh, I'm so sick of these people, these pseudo-intellectuals with their moron followers.
The Fox News decision desk has called Pennsylvania for Donald Trump. This means that Donald Trump will be the 45th president of the United States.
Hail Trump! Hail our people! Hail victory!
Donald Trump gave me a call, and I told him, Mr. President-elect, you're too busy, we don't need to talk. But we still spent over 5 minutes. He said, listen, Alex, I just talked to the kings and queens of the world, world leaders, you name it. But he said, it doesn't matter. I wanted to talk to you to thank your audience. It shows he's not the average elitist. These stuck-up nobodies who believe they control the world. We're going to drain the swamp, and you know you're scum. And we're just here to let you know you're scum.
And, of course, on the first day, it was known that there were 31 strikes in Syria and Iraq. You know, the bombs are dropping in continuation. Sounded to me like it got a little kick up.
You know, I've admired Ron Paul and known him and been a friend, I guess, for 20 years. I've been interviewing him 21 years, maybe friends the last 10, but it's not the same as it is with Trump. Trump is so fire-breathing, so energetic, so cunning, so real, and he's having results so amazing that it just makes me be endeared to Trump. I'm ready to die for Trump at this point.
According to an interview with the New York Times that ran over this past weekend, the Times interviewed Alex Jones. Jones claims that he and Donald Trump speak on the phone regularly, not as an interview on his show, just speaking to each other on the phone, talking about things.
Senior U.S. officials are telling NBC News that the Trump administration is moving ahead with plans to make it easier for the CIA and the military to target terrorists with drone strikes, even if it means tolerating more civilian casualties.
We turn now to look at Yemen, where the U.S. is also rapidly expanding military operations. The U.S. has reportedly launched more than 49 strikes across the country this month. According to the New York Times, that's more strikes than the U.S. has ever carried out in a single year in Yemen.
The Wall Street Journal first broke the story last night that the White House was handing over the power to conduct lethal strikes to the CIA and military with no requirement for a presidential sign-off.
Meanwhile, the New York Times is reporting today that the Trump administration has approved the resumption of sales of precision-guided munitions to Saudi Arabia. President Obama froze some of these weapon sales last year due to concern about civilian casualties in Saudi Arabia's expanding war in Yemen.
Under the Obama administration, the CIA used drones for intelligence gathering, while the military conducted actual strikes. According to the journal, that approval has already been exercised. The CIA first used its new authority in late February in a strike on a senior al-Qaeda leader in Syria.
And they're doing it. They're delivering. And it's so well thought out. It's so good. I've studied history. I've covered politics for 25 years, 21 on air. And I've never seen anything like this. This is bigger than 1776.
It is clear that Donald Trump is talking to Alex Jones, probably the craziest person on the radio, about policy decisions.
Fox News has now confirmed the United States military has launched dozens of Tomahawk missiles on sites in Syria.
And quite frankly, it's a stroke of genius if it turns out to work. It's much better than the Hillary and Obama plan and the rest of it.
I would certainly not do first strike. I think that once the nuclear alternative happens, it's over. At the same time, we have to be prepared. I can't take anything off the table.
He just got my vote.
Because you look at some of these countries,
you look at
North Korea.
No first strike that Obama started.
China should solve
we'll
that
nuke
problem.
Them first. No.
China should go into North Korea. China is totally powerful.
Peace through strength. He's the man.
China keeps pushing. The only option is full commitment to hit China preemptively. That's the only way to survive this nuclear war, and Trump knows it. And Russia has already been told they better stand down. The United States is preparing to nuke China. So get ready, assholes. All of you wanted it, you're going to get it. Turn that off.
Alex Jones claims President Trump called him directly after the election to thank him and his audience for their loyalty. But does Jones really support Trump, or is it all one big act for ratings?
Donald Trump, I hope you can help uncripple America. Thank you so much, sir.
Every day, millions watch, read, or listen to Alex Jones, one of President Trump's biggest and most controversial cheerleaders.
I just want to finish by saying your reputation's amazing. I will not let you down. You will be very, very impressed, I hope.
Praise from then-candidate Trump, even though Jones, the alt-right conspiracy theorist behind the site InfoWars, claimed the tragedy at Sandy Hook, where 20 children were shot and killed, was a hoax.
Sandy Hook is a synthetic, completely fake, with actors.
Now, the Austin American Statesman reports lawyers for Jones are saying the man behind those radical ideas, which garnered more than a billion YouTube views, is just, quote, playing a character, that he's a performance artist. The shocking claim coming during a pretrial custody hearing between Jones and his ex-wife. Reporter Jonathan Tillove has been in court covering the case for the paper.
One of Alex Jones's lawyers said that to hold Alex Jones accountable for the character he plays on air would be like holding Jack Nicholson accountable for the role he played of the Joker in Batman.
Jones' ex-wife claims he's not a stable person, capable of caring for their three children full time.
Saying outrageous things is really good for ratings, right? It can help you get shares and views and traffic and money. And yet saying really outrageous things does not help in the context of a custody battle.
Alex Jones has been my friend for 20 years. He's fucking crazy. I showed everybody how crazy he was on my podcast by getting him high and drunk and have him talk about interdimensional child molesters.
I don't need a bullhorn. I don't need any other. The will of the Republic will dominate this BS. Yeah.
1776
will commence again. You like it? This is just the info war. Imagine you get in a physical fight with us. It's over. You understand that? I know you do now, don't you? We haven't taken the gloves off. And if you want to keep pushing with your commie Chinese, everybody else, we're going to blow your ass off the map. All the secret weapons ain't in the control of you anymore, are they? They're now in the hands of George Washington 2.0.
On the one hand, they're always talking about tearing down the state, about blowing it up, about watering the tree of liberty. And on the other hand, you know, they're very authoritarian and they're worried about lawlessness. And it's a contradiction that produces a lot of crazy stuff. The Protocols of the Elders of Zion is actually the script that he's reading from. He may not even know it himself. And it was deeply important to Hitler It's been deeply important to the far right in this country. And what it claims is that there has been a Jewish plot almost from, you know, for thousands of years to take over the world, to install a Davidic king in Jerusalem and completely control the world through the power of money.
Der Völker Streit und Hass untereinander. Der wird gepflegt von ganz bestimmten Interessenten. Es ist eine kleine, wurzellose, internationale Clique, die die Völker gegeneinander hetzt, die nicht will, dass sie zur Ruhe kommen. Es sind das die Menschen, die überall und nirgends zu Hause sind, die nirgends einen Boden haben, auf den sie gewachsen sind, sondern die heute in Berlin leben, morgen genauso gut in Brüssel sein können, übermorgen in Paris oder mit in Prag oder in Wien oder in London und die sich überall zu Hause fühlen. Es sind die Einzigen, die wirklich als internationale Elemente anzusprechen sind, weil sie überall ihre Geschäfte betätigen können. The far right-wing narrative is that there's this looming threat, and this looming threat wants to take the Republic of the United States, take its sovereignty away. They want one world government. The last generation, it was communism, you know, one world communism. Working through the UN, working through the Bilderberg Group. 200 years ago, it was the Illuminati. Now people are worried about Sharia and the Arabs, but it's always this other. And when you steep yourself in right-wing conspiracy theory, you realize you're constantly reading the same story. You could take a document from the 1890s and just replace the name Rothschild with George Soros, and you would have the same, you know, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference.